My, 31M, wife, 27F, cheated on me with another guy multiple times. I have recently discovered this less than 48 hours ago and it is tearing me apart. I'm experiencing a roller coaster of emotions and I don't know what to do. My wife and I have been married for a little over 4 years now and we have had our fair share of problems. Most of those problems have revolved around trust, as I have caught her lying about quite a few things. She has voiced her concerns to me, not supporting her, not doing enough around the house, dismissing her feelings, and I have been actively changing things in hopes of improving our marriage. We both have 2 children from a previous marriage and we currently have a 2-year-old together. The last couple months have been strange and I have had some real suspicions that something was going on behind my back. She came home very late multiple times after being out with friends and there were times when she would come home from work very late as well. She has also been spending an increasing amount of time on her phone as well as spending time in her office by herself. Every time I would walk by her on her phone, she would lock her screen or quickly switch to doing something else. I confronted her about it and I was told that I was being an asshole for not trusting her. She also decided to remove her wedding ring a couple months back in an attempt to show me just how frustrated she was with our marriage. About a week ago I had to go out of town for work. This is only something I have to do once or twice a year, and I had very little interaction with her while I was gone. I was working in an area that had very poor mobile coverage, so communication was limited to texts, calls. She would always respond to my texts with very short responses, even though I knew that she was always on her phone. When I came home, it just felt like something was off. She acted like she was happy that I was home, but something was telling me it was simply an act. She left the house for a bit that evening and she left her work computer out to play videos for the kids. I went to turn the video off and I noticed a messaging app that was used among her and her coworkers was open. I decided to read through a few conversations and eventually stumbled upon a conversation with a particular coworker. This conversation included my wife explaining how she had found a guy on the side and that she had met with him multiple times. She had told this coworker that we were separated, and he was encouraging her to have a boyfriend on the side whether we were still together or not. He explained that he was married with multiple girlfriends and boyfriends. She said things like, "That's a great idea," referred to the guy she cheated on me with as her boy toy, and that she didn't want to tell me because it would cause a mess. The message concluded with her telling him that he stayed the night with her over the weekend before I came home and that they had sex multiple times. I confronted my wife about this and she admitted to this happening a couple of times. However, she says that she was lying to her coworker about him staying the night at our house. I've since then discovered that she has talked to other guys as well in the last couple months. She also had nudes that she took on Snapchat that weekend that she just didn't get around to sending me. Before I left, she told me that she was moving out and that I forced her to stay by telling her that I didn't want that, even though I told her she could go if that's what she really wanted. She's still lying to me about details of the event, and she is telling me that I am misunderstanding what she said to her coworker. I don't know what to do, because I am afraid that she is going to try and keep our son away from me. She is now begging me to stay and she now wants to work on everything. I think she is mentally unstable at the moment and I am afraid of what might happen when she knows this is over for real. Too long did not read. Wife cheated on me while I was away for work after I already had suspicions that something was going on. She's now begging me to stay and I'm afraid of what she might do if I actually leave. I think you need to go to a lawyer, without telling her, and discuss everything with them. Ask about options for full custody of your child and keep every piece of evidence you have. You say though trust has been an issue for some time. Why would you marry and have a child with someone who doesn't have a good track record of trust? Don't be a pussy, she is using you. Divorce. No. You only have 1 child with this hoe. Only 1. The other kids aren't your problem. Ditch this skank dude. What the fuck, man? Stand up for yourself and tell her to kick rocks. You need to file. Don't leave the home. And go for custody of the child. Those that file first in divorces tend to be ahead of the game. Make moves, man. Get a divorce lawyer ASAP. They will advise you on how to proceed to make sure you don't lose custody of your kids. She's the one who cheated, you should be fine. Try to get your hands on physical evidence to give the lawyer. File for divorce, get a good lawyer. I'm sorry, bro, there's no saving this. A lot of people use children as leverage. But don't stay with a cheater unless you can make the necessary sacrifice for the children. However, staying together for the kids can do more harm than good sometimes, so keep that in mind. This could be the time where you find someone you deserve versus staying with this person that doesn't deserve to have you. Find out who this coworker is and send screenshots of the convo to his spouse after your divorce is finalized. She told you that she lied to her, but in reality you are the one she lied to. She has no reason to lie to her because she enjoys talking about it. Leave her, she doesn't have enough respect for you. How should I, 24F, deal with my angry husband, 28 meters? We got married 4 months after we met. It was fast, but things were going great. We were happy. I previously had a well-paying job, but we both moved to a new city and he didn't like my job, so I stopped. I found him a good job and I'm in school full-time, so the plan was for me to work very little until I finished up in a year. He was a little possessive but very sweet, loving, supportive, and funny. And he had made it sound like he really wanted to go to school and learn. The first big issue was shortly after we moved in. I previously lived alone with my cat. She was a healthy, happy little cat when we lived together. But he didn't like her. We started having some arguments about the way he would treat her. Eventually, even though she was healthy, she ended up dying while I was at work. This made my family very suspicious and they began to think he hurt her. That's made him very angry. Although I didn't want any new pets, he convinced me we needed 2 new kittens that we couldn't necessarily afford. They began hurting each other very badly when we weren't around. I was also very bothered by how he treated them. He would call them names, pick them up when they clearly wanted to be alone, force them to be next to him, etc. I told him that he needs to respect bodily autonomy because he also thinks it's okay to touch me when I don't want NTOB. There are at least 2 occasions where he forced me into sex that left my genitalia visibly injured. This, along with him getting angry, and me needing to pick up another job on top of a rigorous full-time program, decreased my sex drive a bit. This made him even more angry. He began insisting that I'm cheating on him even though that never happened. Never even close. He started to become upset that I would refer to my classmates as friends. Or state that I would like to make friends since this is an unfamiliar town for both of us. I stopped talking to my classmates as much and he became upset that if he wanted to spend time with me it had to be while I was studying or doing homework. I suggested he learn some new things with me since his job is a new field to him and he said he wanted to go to school. He got very offended any time I suggested this and said I was trying to control him. Now, somehow both of the cats are injured and one is in horrible shape. He doesn't want to take her to the vet even though she's bleeding, struggling to breathe, and unable to eat. He says if I take her, we're getting a divorce. He says I never listened to him. But I'm starting to feel like listening to him is what's causing me problems. He also manipulated me into not inviting my family to the wedding. Help. You are in an abusive relationship and clearly need to leave him. He is manipulating and controlling you. He is isolating you from everything and everyone. He stripped you of your job. Pulled you away from your family. And now he's limiting your ability to make new friends. He's abusing your cats and getting more angry in the process. He is a textbook abuser. Soon he will be punching walls, calling you names and roughing you up like he did with the cats. He'll say he's the only one that does any work and pays for everything. And that you should be grateful. Then he'll start trashing you and saying that you are lazy and good for nothing. Then the pushing, the choking, punching walls and throwing things. Leave now or you will be dead next. Classic abuser. Go watch Maid on Netflix. Take your cat to the vet. You'll both be better off. You married an abuser and you need to make a plan to leave immediately. Is there someone you can contact for help or somewhere safe you can go? We got married 4 months after we met. The real reason you two got married so fast was so that he could trap you more and stop the pretending that he isn't an abuser. Even though you don't say it, there are more than enough clues to say that you are in an abusive marriage. Even if he doesn't hit you, he is still mentally abusive. He's also isolating you, which is another very common abuse tactic, to take away any support system to make you easier to control and less likely to leave. I think you should call a domestic violence hotline for your region to help you plan your escape and to better understand what is really happening. Divorce. You should not have married this person. I would leave before you get pregnant. Take the cat to the vet now. In fact, get them both to the vet. He's hurting them. Animal cruelty is a federal felony, so see if you can prove anything. This relationship is like reading an abusive relationship checklist. You married a psycho, and you need to get yourself and those kittens out of there. Today, my daughter, 7F, told me a disturbing story. What should I do now? Trigger warning. Possible abuse. and #X200B. My daughter, 7F, came home from school today and told me a disturbing story about her friend at school, 7F. She said her friend, we will call her Bella, had hurt herself and needed stitches. Bella told her that her dad used a needle and thread to give her stitches and it hurt really bad and she couldn't stop screaming, so her dad put a shirt in her mouth to keep her quiet. I asked questions like, how did she get hurt? Is her dad a doctor? And, did she have to go to the hospital? But my daughter said she didn't know. She said Bella said her dad told her not to tell anyone about it. All of this seemed super shady and disturbing to me. I have met Bella's mother many times, in public settings, and I've never met or seen her husband, Bella's dad. And previously to this year, there was nothing that seemed off about the family. This year Bella has missed a good amount of school and my daughter always mentions when Bella is absent because she likes playing with her. I thought that was odd but didn't really think twice about it, just thought maybe she was sick. Then Bella taught my daughter how to circumvent school parental controls on the internet and told my daughter she watches Squid Game at home. These were recent incidents and started to make me pay more attention to what she says about Bella. My daughter is not one to embellish, lie, but I know kids can be kids and make stuff up. So I'm not sure if Bella or my daughter could just be making stuff up, but at this point I'm concerned and am considering reporting the stitches incident. I feel somewhat guilty as I know her mother and don't know if I should just talk to her, but if there is truly abuse at home, I doubt she would be honest with me and it may blow back on Bella. Should I talk to the school about what my daughter told me? Should I go to the police? I would think if Bella or my daughter were lying, it would be easy enough to disprove. I just don't know who to tell, and I hope by saying something Bella doesn't get in trouble for talking about it with my daughter. Too long did not read. My daughter's friend Bella may be being abused at home. What should I do? Please, please, please contact the school or CPS. Even if Bella is lying or exaggerating, a child that young should not be telling such disturbing stories. It's okay, you only know their first names, you know the school she goes to, and CPS can handle it from there. Doing nothing about this is doing something. You have the potential to save a child. Call the school and tell them what your daughter said. They are mandatory reporters who are required to call the Child Protective Services. If you know Bella's friend's name, address, and contacts, call Child Welfare and report them yourself. If you don't, call the school and talk to them. They're mandated reporters and will call if they suspect abuse, and have Bella's friend's contact information. As a child welfare expert and professional, call Child Protective Services. Call CPS. You don't have to give your name. Better safe than sorry, crying if they don't do anything, and you hear it's got worse from your daughter or however, keep calling. You might be her only voice. Please childline this. Unless you are a mandated reporter, you can remain anonymous. I mean, before you go nuclear on this family, I would ascertain whether or not her father is a doctor. My kid's mom is an MD and she has definitely done some minor procedures at home that caused some screaming even though he was fully numbed. He's definitely not being abused, just avoiding the time and money it takes to go to the hospital for something his mom can easily handle. Perhaps Bella needed a few stitches and Dr. Dad decided to do it himself instead of spending half a day and thousands of dollars in a during a pandemic. Just talk to this kid's parents before jumping to any conclusions. Call CPS. I was called upon by CPS when my child was 6. He had some interesting drawings apparently. Initially I was upset. Drawings? Really? So they came, inspected, asked me questions of discipline, to which I admitted to spanking, etc. They left, and all was cleared. Was it uncomfortable for me? Yes. Was I pissed? Of course. Looking back, was the intention to protect my kid? Yes. I'd rather have someone watching for Lid's safety than a little bit of uncomfortable feelings. If nothing is found, the family will just be pissed. If there is something wrong, you will have saved a child. My girlfriend doesn't like that I wear glasses? Okay, my girlfriend seems to look down on people who wear glasses. I remember before we were together and just hanging out, she told me two of her colleagues were fighting over a guy and she said she would never go so low and fight with another girl for some guy, and especially not one who wears glasses. That hurt. Now that we're together, the other day we took some photos together and while looking at them she made a comment like, wow, you really are handsome even if you wear glasses. Don't let anyone else tell you otherwise. Again, this hurt, but she stepped back by saying a lot of people don't find glass wearers attractive. If we watch something on TV and some very fine attractive dude that wears glasses appears, she will say he's ugly just because he wears glasses, really? Another thing is that she is very beautiful and I know how many people hit her up and try to ask her out. She is very honest and tells me about all of them, and that makes me jealous a bit, but it's okay, I trust her. My coworker asked me out the other day. She didn't know I was into a relationship, so I gently rejected her and I told my girlfriend about it, like, aha. See, you're not the only one who gets asked out, haha. She made a comment like, who asked you out? Who would look at you? That really came off as offensive, and I asked why nobody would look at me, and she played it off like, nobody but me. And I asked why again, and she said it's because I wear glasses. Again, that many people find it unattractive. I really am speechless. I know she loves me and finds me attractive, but the glasses are the only thing she finds unattractive. When we get intimate, the first thing she does is remove my glasses. I am just trying to see, damn it. I am considering wearing lenses, and I actually used a couple of years ago, but I just don't like them and can't tolerate them, and I hate the idea of changing myself to be the way somebody else wants me. Someone who loves you for who you are is not going to get hung up on the fact that you have to wear glasses to see. This is toxic behavior. She is the one that needs to change her behavior, not you. Your girlfriend is more shallow than a wading pool full of Kardashians, and she's offensively shallow. I'd be gone. Whatever you do, do not do something that makes you uncomfortable or change yourself in ways you don't want to, just to impress someone who isn't worth impressing in the first place. Your girlfriend sucks. You don't want to have a future or children with a judgmental asshole. By the way, I am a girl and I love glasses. She made a comment like, who asked you out? Who would look at you? This is dumpable right there, though. If a man said something like this to a woman, and, nobody would look at you but me, it would be clear negging and a sign that that man was trying to lower the woman's self-esteem so that she would think she could never do better. UGF has issues beyond the glasses. She all but put you down with the, who would look at you part. Find someone who values you for you and appreciates what you have to offer, who builds you up instead of trying to tear you down. Do you want to keep taking hits to your self-esteem? I wouldn't. Don't ask us. You're the one who's with the asshole. I guess her hotness outweighs being treated the way you are? Don't you dare wear contacts for her. You may love each other, but maybe you guys are not compatible. Your girlfriend sucks and is mean.